Hi DA, this is Michael from OTC, OnlineToefl Course.com, and how are you doing on this Saturday? I'm going to listen to your integrated speaking practice test right now. Let me get the rubrics here. Okay, here we go. Integrated rubrics, and you're doing integrated speaking, right? Okay, let's listen to your task.
Professor describes two ways roads can affect the environment. The first one is that roads help plants to move from one area to another one where they compete with native plants for their main resources. He gives an example about yellow turnstile plant to illustrate it. Its seeds get stuck to the tires of cars and move from one area to another one where they compete with native plants for their main resources such as water. As a result, it becomes hard for native plants to survive there. The second one is that roads act such as barriers that divide animals' habitat into small areas where it's hard to find enough food for some animals. He gives an example about kit foxes to illustrate it. They feed on mice that live in open and large areas, but it's hard to find enough food because the roads divide the mice habitat into small areas. And that's how the professor illustrates.
Based on the rubrics here, you have what's called highly intelligible, and then you have what's called generally intelligible and coherent. So you're not highly intelligible yet. So certain vowel, certain consonant sounds, words in general, you're not always pronouncing them clearly. So that's putting you, I'm going to put you around 22 to 23 points out of 30. Let's listen to it one more time.
In this lecture, the professor describes two ways roads can affect the environment. Professor describes two ways roads can affect the environment.
That word there. Is it two-way toads can affect the environment? I'm not getting that particular word at about 3 to 4 seconds. If anybody at YouTube knows what she said there, put it in the comments below so I can see it. Thank you.
The first one is that roads help plants to move from one area to another one where...
Roads. I got it. So it's a long sound. You just need to make the longer vowel longer. Roads.
They compete with native plants for their main resources. He gives an example about yellow turnstile plant to illustrate it.
Yeah, I'm having trouble understanding that word you said. You're talking about a certain kind of plant, but you didn't pronounce it very clearly.
Its seeds get stuck to the tires of cars and move from one area to another one where they compete with native plants for their main resources such as water.
Okay.
As a result, it becomes hard.
And that's a good transition word. I like that word to help show the connection of your ideas.
For native plants to survive there. The second one is that roads act such as barriers that divide...
That roads act as barriers.
Animals' habitat into small areas where it's hard to find enough food for some animals. He gives an example about kit foxes to illustrate it.
And this is about kit foxes, am I right? Kit foxes?
They feed on mice that live in open...
So he gives you example kit foxes. Let's listen to how you said that again.
...areas where it's hard to find enough food for some animals. He gives an example about kit foxes to illustrate it. They feed on mice that live in...
So he gives the example kit foxes. I would combine those two and say kit foxes, which... feed on mice, or to illustrate, the professor gives the example kit foxes, which blah blah blah, and then you connect those two sentences together, show a little bit more advanced grammar.
And large areas, but it's hard to find enough food because the roads divide the mice habitat into small areas, and that's how the professor illustrates.
Okay, so I think you can do a little bit better on your long vowel sounds. So I think it's good if you go to the pronunciation area of my course, review the vowel sounds of American English. I think there's about 13 different sounds. I have accent reduction videos for every one of them. So take some time and practice those vowels until you feel comfortable pronouncing them a little more clearly. Right? So that's why I'm going to put you at 22 to 23 points. You're generally intelligible, but not every single word in there. I have to kind of stop and go back and listen. And remember that I got headphones on here, right? See this? Yeah, I actually have headphones. I turn the volume up when I want to hear you. So most people can't do that when they're hearing you. So it'll be difficult. There's some things that you're saying that native speakers are going to have some trouble understanding. And that's what you want to work on. All right? And thank you for doing this practice test.